have no doubt his generosity is well represented by his surviving partner.
We are the representatives of the society for the relief of poverty.
Are you indeed?
The ragged children's clothing charity.
The relief of starvation in city streets.
The gentlewomen's provision of civil fare to the deserving poor.
Humbug.
At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is Mr. Scrooge, is it not?
Yes, it's Scrooge.
Mr. Marley is deceased. Yes, of course. You said so.
Unfortunately deceased.
At this season of the year, it is more than usually desirable that we should make some slight provision for the poor and homeless.
Who suffer greatly at the present time.
Many are in want of common necessities, sir.
Hundreds are in want of common comfort, sir.
Poor people?
Yes, Mr. Scrooge.
That is.
They are still, sir.
We wish we could say they were not.
And the poor law in full vigor, is it?
Very busy, sir.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. I was afraid from what you have said. Something had gone wrong with those admirable institutions.
But they scarcely furnish Christmas cheer to the multitude.
At this time of the year, poverty is keenly felt.
What shall we put it down for?
Nothing.
We understand.
And it's not gift. That's very generous.
A modest benefactor, Mr. Scrooge.
Who doesn't wish to see his name published?
I wish to be left alone. I don't make merry at Christmas, and I can't afford to make either people merry. I support the poorhouse, sir, with the taxes I pay and the jail. They cost enough. Let those who are badly off make use of such luxuries.
Many would rather die, sir. They go to the poorhouse.
If that's what they prefer, let them die. Why not? Degrees of surplus population. It's not my business if they'd rather die. It's enough for a man to occupy his own business and mine occupies me continually. So good afternoon, you both.
Mary.
Good afternoon.
See clearly that it would be useless to pursue their quest.
The two charity workers withdrew.